I'm the only person on this stage who will say that climate is the number one priority for me. Vice President Biden won't say it. Senator Warren won't say it. It's a state of emergency, and I would declare a state of emergency on day one. I would use the emergency powers of the presidency. I know that we have to do this. I've spent a decade fighting and beating oil companies, stopping pipelines, stopping fossil fuel plants, ensuring clean energy across the country. I know that we have to do this. I also know that we can do this. I would make this the number one priority of my foreign policy as well. We can do this and create literally millions of good-paying union jobs across this country. I would make sure that my climate policy was led by environmental justice and members of the communities where this society has chosen to put our air and water pollution, which are low-income black and brown communities. And when we ask, how are we going to pull this country together? How about this? We take on the biggest challenge in history, we save the world, and we do it together. Do you think that would pull America together? I do.
Quickly, Vice President Biden, you were name-checked there. I'd like to give you a chance
to
respond.
Yeah, I was. I think it is the existential threat to humanity. It's the number one issue. And I might add, I don't really need kind of a lecture from my friend. While I was passing the first climate change bill, and that Politifact said was a game changer, while I managed the $90 billion recovery plan, investing more money in infrastructure that related to clean energy than any time we've ever done it. My friend was producing more coal mines and produced more coal around the world, according to the press, than all of Great Britain produces. Now, I welcome him back into the fold here, and he's been there for a long while. But the idea that we talk about where we started and how we are, let's get this straight. I think it is the existential threat of all time.
Thank you, Mr. Vice President. You may respond, Mr. Steyer.
Look, I came to the conclusion over 10 years ago that climate was the absolute problem of our society and was the unintended consequence of our whole country being based on fossil fuels. Everybody in this room has lived in an economy based on fossil fuels, and we all have to come to the same conclusion that I came to over a decade ago. If we're waiting for Congress to pass one of the bills, and I know everybody on this stage cares about this, but Congress has never passed an important climate bill ever. This is a problem which continues to get worse. That's why I'm saying it's a state of emergency. That's why I'm saying it's priority one. If it isn't priority one, it's not going to get done. And this is something where we absolutely have to address it up front. We have to make it the most important thing. And we can use it to rebuild and reimagine what the United States is. We can be the moral leaders of the world again while we clean up our air and water and create millions of good-paying jobs.
Senator Sanders, I'm going to ask you to jump in
here. I was also named in that.
Tom, you stated...
You were.
You talked about the need to make climate change a national emergency. I've introduced legislation to just do that. Now, I disagree with the thrust of the original question, because your question has said, what are we going to do in decades? We don't have decades. What the scientists are telling us, we don't get our act together within the next 8 or 9 years. We're talking about cities all over the world, major cities going underwater. We're talking about increased drought, talking about increased extreme weather disturbances. The United Nations is telling us that in the years to come, there are going to be hundreds of millions of climate refugees causing national security issues all over the world. What we have got to do tonight, and I will do as president, is to tell the fossil fuel industry that their short-term profits are not more important than the future of this planet. And by the way, the fossil fuel industry is probably criminally liable because they have lied and lied and lied when they had the evidence that their carbon products were destroying the planet. And maybe we should think about prosecuting them as well.
Thank you, Senator Sanders.
Hey there, I'm Chris Hayes from MSNBC. Thanks for watching MSNBC on YouTube. If you want to keep up to date with the videos we're putting out, you can click subscribe just below me or click over on this list to see lots of other great videos.